Good morning, everybody. In our opening hymn, I will say, Alleluia, Alleluia, that the holy anthems rise. Alleluia, Alleluia, let the holy anthems rise. And the choirs of heaven shout it in the temple of the skies. Let the mountains skip with gladness, and the joyful valleys ring with Hosanna in the highest to our Savior and our King. And as we gather today, one of our special intentions at this Mass is for Kathy Torbort, a longtime parishioner who is very sick, and we pray for her recovery and her healing so that we will remember her at this Mass along with the other intentions. And then at the end of Mass, we will have a special rosary prayer, the healing mysteries of the rosary prayed for her. So I'm glad to see so many of you here at Mass today for her as we remember her in our prayers. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let's acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, and what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have united the many nations in confessing your name, grant that those reborn in the font of baptism may be one in the faith of their hearts and the homage of their deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Times of refreshment and send you the God of
How wonderful your name in all the earth.
O Lord, our God, how wonderful your name in all the earth.
O Lord, our God, how glorious is your name over all the earth. What is man that you should be mindful of him, or the son of man that you should care for him?
O Lord, our God, how wonderful your name is.
You have made him little less than the angels and crowned him with glory and honor. You have given him rule over the works of your hands, putting all things under his feet.
O Lord, our God, how wonderful your name in all the earth.
All sheep and oxen, yes, and the beasts of the fields, the birds of the air, the fishes of the sea, and whatever swims the path of the seas.
O Lord, our God, how wonderful your name in all the earth.
Alleluia, alleluia. Risen Lord, who has come to us. And we know how Jesus his ministries was the healing of the sick. And we continue that ministry in here in the church, that we continue to offer up our prayers for those who are sick, for those who are in need of the resurrected Lord's healing, so that we have that wonderful and beautiful sacrament of the anointing of the sick. And I administered that sacrament to Kathy in the hospital last week as I came to pray over her and pray for the Holy Spirit to be with her. And all of you gathered here today, you who are friends and family of Kathy, that you are here to also, as people of resurrected faith, to bring that faith to Jesus and to pray for his healing. And we don't know, and we pray for that healing, and we don't know what the Lord's will is, but we continue to have trust and hope in the Lord. And that's what we come today, that we trust and hope in the Lord, and we pray for one of our dear sisters. Kathy has been so much a part of our parish for so many years, so that we remember her today at this Mass. Pray for her, the rosary after Mass. So I invite you to please stay and remain for the rosary. And, you know, something very, you know, when someone gets, someone who's well known gets sick, the people of faith come together. You come together and say, we have to pray. We have to pray for one of our loved ones. And that is what happened today, the people came and said, we have to pray for Kathy. And I said, yes, we do. And please take it upon yourself to bring others to come to pray for her today. So that's what you have done. And that is a beautiful thing to do. That we bring our faith and hope in Jesus, and we pray for her and her family who sit here. Could we fit any more people into that one pew here? But you are here today also. So Jesus had his ministry, was a ministry of healing, that we also pray now that for the healing of our dear sister Kathy. And now opening our minds and hearts, let us bring our needs before the Lord. For our Holy Mother, the Church, may Christ reignite her missionary work in the world today. Let us pray to the Lord. For all civil servants, may Christ inspire a new passion in their work to serve others. Let us pray to the Lord. Officials here in Oak Lawn, may they serve us, the people of Oak Lawn, well. Let us pray to the Lord. For those undergoing trials or suffering, may God bless them with strength and courage. Let us pray to the Lord. For our faith community, during this octave of Easter, may Christ bring us to new awareness of our mission as disciples. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have passed away in the hope of the resurrection, may Christ's victory over death bring them to new life. Let us pray to the Lord. And for those who we remember in a special way at this Mass, Jose Makanake, Catherine McGuire, Nancy Munda, and Catherine Turber, let us pray to the Lord. And on this Holocaust Memorial Day, let us remember Almighty Father, hear our prayers today as we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this good bread to offer, which earth has given to you and has today, will become for us the bread of life. And pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the church.
Graciously be pleased, O Lord, to accept the sacrificial gifts we offer joyfully, both for those who have been reborn in hope of your increased health in heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Pastor has been sacrificed. For he is a true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome and pass with joy. Every land and every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim,
holy, 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 holy
Lord,
have mercy,
have
mercy,
have
mercy,
have mercy,
have mercy,
have mercy, have
mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy,
have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have
mercy,
have mercy,
have
mercy,
have mercy,
have
mercy,
have
mercy,
have
mercy,
have
mercy,
have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, the supper was ended to the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. And therefore, we celebrate the memorial death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, that we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Let our Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring it from the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop, and his auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Catherine of Alexandria, and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son and Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And let us pray the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold, it takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. the St. Joseph prayer. St. Joseph, watch over us and care for us. Just as St. Joseph, watch over us and care for us, just as you care for the child Jesus, that by your help may we come to know your Son, and so grow in strength and wisdom and the favor of God. Amen.
Amen.
And just please, a reminder for those of you who are here to pray the Rosary of Healing. We will start there shortly after Mass ends, as we offer up our prayers for our dear sister, Kathy. And also today, from 3 to 6, is our adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. And we ask you to come in through the wood doors on the side and sign yourself in. And that is today from 3 to 6. Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure us of eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks
be to God. And I will sing verse 2 of Alleluia, Alleluia, let the holy anthems rise. Alleluia, Alleluia, like the sun. From out the way, Christ has risen up in triumph from the darkness of the grave. Glorious splendor of the nations and the land of endless pre-day, Christ the very